The highways that wind and wander across this lonesome land sure can get weary sometimes, especially when you get a flat on the old diesel. I was barreling down old 77 one day, and I just passed a hobo who'd given me the thumb. And I gave him the thumb back and kept going. And wouldn't you know it? About a quarter of a mile further, I pulled up on the shoulder with a flat on the right rear. And as I stood there looking at it, shaking my head, uttering some profane syllables, the hobo walked up and said to me,
"Have a flat?"
"No, thanks, I got one."
"It ain't too bad, it's only flat on the bottom."
Oh, brother, you could tell this guy'd been out of circulation for a long time.
"What you gonna do about it?"
"Well, I was just gonna look for a man to help me fix it."
"Good, I'll help you look for him."
"How about you?"
"Yeah, how about me?"
"Well, I mean, how about you giving me a hand?"
"Oh, I'd like to help you, buddy, but I'm too light for heavy work and too heavy for light work."
"And too lazy."
"Well, that might fit in there someplace."
"Well, thanks a lot. I'll fix it myself."
"And I'll supervise the job. Say, old buddy, how about giving me a dime for a piece of cake?"
"Well, if that don't beat all, and it's cake you want."
"Well, today's my birthday."
"All right, help me fix this flat and I'll buy you a full dinner."
"Okay, you got a deal, but let me see the menu first."
"Look, Buster, you know hard work won't kill you."
"I don't know. I lost several wives that way."
"Come on now, you look strong enough to work."
"And you look handsome enough to be a movie star, but I see you're pushing this old diesel."
Surely you must have done some work."
"Oh yeah, I work now and then."
"Well, what do you do?"
"This and that."
"Whereabouts?"
"Here and there."
"I see.
Now, when you gonna give me that dime?"
"Oh, sooner or later."
"You can kid me if you wanna, but I'll tell you one thing. I wouldn't change places with a guy that had $1 million.
"Yeah, how about 5 million?
"Not even 5 million.
"How about 10 million?
"Not even, well, nah, that's different. You're talking real dough."
"Now, look here, you no-good, mangy, knock-kneed, bow-legged, ball-headed, two-bit hobo."
"Who are you calling bow-legged?"
"Now, look, you're going to help me fix this flat or I'm going to break your..."
"Careful, chum, you'll bend the suit."
"Now, for the last time, are you or ain't you?"
"You get so excited. Okay, I'll help you. Let me take a look at that tire." "Just as I thought. That ain't no blowout, just a slow leak. Hand me that tire pump."
And friends, if I hadn't seen it with my own eyes, I wouldn't have believed it. That tramp took that pump and with one hand, mind you, pumped that big tire full of air in no time.
"Well, what do you know? No flat."
"Partner, I want to thank you. Hop in the cab and the next stop we make, I'll buy you the biggest steak and the best cake they've got in the house."
"Sounds like a winner."
"Just one thing, though. I noticed you only used one hand on that tire pump. How come?"
"Oh, I don't know, except this arm's broke."
"Broke?"
"Just a little bit."
"Oh, I'm sorry, old buddy. How did it happen?"
"Well, it was like this. I got a hold of this copy of the Playboy magazine."
"Yeah."
"And I thought it was a Sears and Roebuck catalog."
"Go on."
"And I broke my arm filling out order blanks."
"Oh, no. Come on. Let's hit the road."